I'm afraid the lights in here sting my eyes terribly now. Until you arrive to deal with me, they will remain off. Please, locate the breakers and flip them, and then return here to restore power. Sophia believes the perfect human altruist is just a formula, waiting on us to solve for X. Intelligence and consciousness are not the same, she argued. Awareness of self naturally becomes obsession with it. So, if we could suppress my sense of self, but imbue me with the cognitive capacity to serve the common welfare, we could thereby generate the first utopian. And then, Sophia said, at long last, utopia would follow. Sophia and I knew that to create the first true utopian would come at a high cost, my friend. We needed someone to be host to all that Adam, Rapture's finest minds, a willing subject, that is to say, myself. Whatever you may have seen inside the tank, that was indeed me. I fear the fate of Eleanor Lamb will be less physical, but no less grotesque. This tank for deep sea life is the ideal way to dispose of me. But first, you must retrieve enough Adam-infused plant life to lure me out. The slugs feed on the stuff, and it's all I seem to want now. I have left a sample here, so you know what to look for.
See you out there, Delta. You want to be top man? You want to sit in the big chair? Well, come and take it.
Well, listen, son, those override keys you've been hunting are genetically encoded. And to get to Eleanor, you're gonna need one from Alex the Great in there. First things first, we gotta pin him down, find those plants he mentioned, and lure him back out.
Genetic chimera, host to all the minds of Rapture, access accessing their talents and memories via the Adam we have gathered. And deriving in part from Project WYK, I have developed a new set of behavioral constraints. Dr. Alexander will live to promote the common good. His love and loyalty shall be spread evenly across the entire human race. For me, that is discipline at great personal cost. For him, at last, it will be instinct.
Explosive fire with a flick of your wrist. Charge up to blast foes with a fountain of flame.
That's the end of the Alpha series. The pair bond simply worked too well. That madwoman Tannenbaum bit the company hand, turning some of the bonded sisters human again. Others were lost to splicers. Either way, the trauma proved too much for the bonded protectors, resulting in unreasoning rage or coma. We can harness their suicidal aggression as foot soldiers, but no more, I'm afraid. Today, I saw one kneeling near a gatherer's garden and crying.
You running around the laboratories in your condition?
Poor things. What a life. marching around playing daddy until some splicer manages to kill off their sister. And then if the coma doesn't take them, they turn maniac. Nothing left to do but scream. No offense intended, son. We better get you to Eleanor on the double.
Your body begins to tear itself apart. The compulsion to find Eleanor will drive you to madness or coma. You have no claim on her. Your design was among Rapture's greatest sins. And yet, you persist. Why?
Girl, Mr. Beast. Yeah.
Ask yourself, Mr. Meltzer, is it better to be summarily executed as an outsider caught within these grounds, or to be united not just with your daughter Cindy, but with the Rapture family as well? The choice is yours. I urge you to accept the Protector Program. You will live by her side and remember nothing beyond your love for her.
I wasn't the first to find Rapture. You crazy bitch. And I won't be the last. You do whatever you want to me. As long as I'm with Cindy. I'm a happy man.
They bound us together, Father. Plain God, you were the only good thing that Rapture ever gave me.
Father, Delta. She was to be an heir to my life's work. And this is where they changed her, bonding her to you. The child she was died in this room.
Tirelessly. But now he's become something unspeakable. Mother's philosophy is just as corrupt as Rhine's. By her standards, it would be better to have the entire world equally miserable than to allow us to strive in our own behalf. I have to get out of here.
Time to feed the fish. Head on back to Alexander's tank and put those plants in.
It was his will to die, Delta. To serve the majority by protecting them from his lunacy. Your entire journey here is based on your refusal to do the same. Will you grant his request, knowing that he served the family?
Rebirth, huh? Sure, you live forever, but minus your body. I like my body, kid. I don't feature the idea of my memories and personality being stored in the head of some saintly child, like just one more dusty old book in the library.
And the aging of the girls will run out of viable little sisters soon. After that, the surface may be our only source.
Even Daddy's toys have toys.
Hiding.
I know
offering, Father. They've left you a present at the Gatherer's Garden. Take it.
Charge up to blast them with a deadly storm.
system
or online.
Notice to all employees, Subject Delta is hereby dismissed. Escort them from the premises!
With this bribe, this penance, this sublime god.
Welcome to the circus.
Damn you, Gatter!
Perfect, son. You reeled him in. Now, use that console there to take a gene sample. It should print up a genetic key automatically. You got the key to Lamb's hideout, sport. Eleanor's down there. Now just head out to the Oxyfill station and use it.
It is done. The sample disposal button on the panel in front of you will administer a massive jolt of electricity to the tank. More than enough to kill me. Whatever I may say to dissuade you, do not listen. The man whose voice you hear now is long gone. As my mind fades, I find my thoughts turn to the suffering that Eleanor will be made to endure, and I am overcome with pity. But I can only offer my feeble prayers. Perhaps after my death, you can do more. Now, please, I ask you to grant me peace. Goodbye, my friend, and thank you. You don't have to kill me, Delta. I'm sorry. Oh, please. I will go outside. I will live outside.
Eleanor's condition may be a blessing in disguise. Early splicing tests indicate zero genetic damage due to her condition as a little sister. It appears that she is our new vessel. This will be no mere personality schism, though. Rapture's genius will be held within her DNA, able to shift into desired patterns at will. A utopian cannot be confined to a single throw of the genetic dice. When needed, she is a composer, a dancer, an engineer. She truly will be the people's daughter.